And welcome back. We last left off on stage 25 and we're on to 24. And I am the terror that flaps in the night. I am Darkwing Duck. And my rush jet is this guy that shoots backwards. And my rush coil is one of the sneezy turtles. Achoo! And we're on to stage 24. Bicycle Lantern. Central Computer. Score 67.75. It's Final Fantasy 7, I think. We got all this digital stuff going on. Okay, stuff's getting interesting. I got hit by a brain. We got a lot of ladders going on. Was there any reason to fall down? I don't think so. Interesting layout decision. Maybe it'll play a role later on. These ladders aren't, like, right. Like, if you look at the... Yeah. I guess that explains it. Oops. I slid on accident. The ladders are kind of funky, so going up seems to work. Does it mess up here, too? No? Okay, so it has nothing to do with what it looks like. This person just maybe need a little more help on the ladders. Alright. Introducing those Ringman platform thingies. That bullet left the stratosphere. And you could jump under through them from the bottom, I mean. Uh-oh. Well, this is good. I can kill these guys without having to get close. All right, and then we got the rainbow ones, too. I don't know if they're considered the same gimmick or if the creator got both of them or if they just wanted to use both of them together. Oh, that was really mean. I could have paid more attention. Man. All right, we're back. Oh, maybe I could have shot that guy if I would have waited a little more. So I'm just going to have to hold right this time. That's a little rough for being this early in the stage. It kind of just introduced things, and then the first challenge with those guys where you see them actually move kind of just lands on your head. Not the best design. You know, we got this guy dropping bombs. Huh. Not super interesting yet. Oh, I guess there's spikes now. You know, I'm back here again. All right. Okay, so I can... You know, there's no real reason to even wait there, though. Wow, you know, I had high hopes for this stage, but so far, I'm not super impressed. Okay, so... Jump, please. Oh, I guess I'm supposed to do that. Maybe introduce that in an area where I won't just die from falling to where, you know, I can't even see that I'm gonna die. This room should have just been lifted up. The spikes shouldn't have been there, and it should have taught me that first before killing me. You're jumping the gun a little bit. Like, there has been a bunch of rooms that are just kind of there and very easy, and then I got insta-killed twice. So far, not too great. Let's hope it picks up and gets really interesting later. Secret room maybe? Because this is the ladder bit showing. Nah, it's a key. I'm probably going to need it. Now, which way do these go? That way? Huh. I'm going to try. No. How are you supposed to do that without getting hit? Aw, my bolt. Okay. Well, I got a key. Where they drop the bombs right there. And we're waiting. And we're walking. Stage is kind of there so far. A little annoying with the insta-kills because I had to play a lot. Like, the checkpoint placement. It's more like the room layout. Like, we don't need a checkpoint yet, but... Because of that super... Can I just... Nope. Whatever. I'm getting impatient. Let's go. I've been playing this stage too long already. Gotta do that, drop them. Can do this. That'll drop them. I knew that was gonna happen. Why did I do that? At least I had a checkpoint. Oh my god. I'm gonna show that little part just because the way the layout is, you have to be a lot more careful with your jump than you would expect, because that one little piece right there is hanging down, and so you gotta go like this. If you don't, you're just instantly dead. Man, now I'm worried that I'm gonna just die again. I don't know. Yeah, I can do that. Weird. It's weird how if I'm holding right where I don't go down enough on the ladder, it'll just kill me. Okay. So I gotta... Ugh. This is like... Ugh. Okay, cool. Get him out of the way. Whatever. This is weird. I wonder why the stage got so high. I'm not really enjoying it at all so far. It's... Oh, come on. It's like... It's very weird, because it's like I have barely any room to move. Go like this. Okay. I mean, I at least had time to think of what to do in the room there, but... Can you just leave? These things have way too much health, and you guessed it, they're a Game Boy asset. Cool, I got the key. Now I get to do this part again. But it's gonna be different, because that guy was already on my tail. Let's just go. We're done. Okay, this stage was not impressive at all, and very, very unforgiving. Cheap man. Morning, pal. You probably know who I am, but the creator of the level wanted me to thank Coatless Carl. Coatless Carl. For making an 8-bit version of Genova, a theme from Final Fantasy VII. Whoa! Good job, Coatless Carl. It's the best part of this stage. And I gotta fight this thing in a little room, which we've kind of seen already. That's a tight jump, but hey, you can still make it, so that's good. And I slid right into that. I didn't use weapons in this stage. I don't know if that would have even helped anywhere. Maybe a little bit here and there? 10.5 minutes. Yeah. Eh. I didn't like that stage too much. Let's see what people liked about it. Because I liked the music. I mean, that was cool. But, you know, that's just Final Fantasy music. Honestly, I thoroughly enjoyed this level. The whole aesthetic works really well. The aesthetics were nice, too, with the whole computer idea going on. The aesthetic works really well with the music, and it just feels really good. I feel like the difficulty of this one is on the higher side, but it's still reasonable and scales up while introducing everything properly. Personally, I thought the difficulty went from nothing, just introduction, to you can instantly die. It didn't properly teach that mechanic of dropping the block by hitting the ground platform thing. It didn't properly teach that in, like, a way where I would have understood that's what was supposed to happen. So that room should have just been reworked, and maybe things would have been a little bit better. Okay, so this was a 74. This was also a 74. Some neat interactions with the skull cannons and the ring platforms that gave it more of a puzzly approach. I will give it credit. They were really good ideas. The idea of dropping things with the platforms and having to rush and all that stuff by, like, sliding and stuff. Those were good ideas. I just think the layouts needed a little more work. Maybe not necessarily for every single room, but it needed a better, the difficulty needed to ramp up more evenly, and then yeah, some rooms just need to be reworked. And a 72 here. Where do I fall on the are video games art debate? Me personally, I'm sort of the skeptical, but undeniably, there's one big overlap between video games and all the visual arts. Okay, you found this stage to be artistic. And Judge 4, a 51. There are some decent puzzle setups throughout the level, but some are bogged down by inconsistent cutting wheel behavior. Yeah, I agree. After the first few are stationary, having one just land on you and pretty much guarantee a death if you don't know it's coming is very rude. Yeah, I had that issue too. Strange spike placements that certainly don't cause issues, but at the same time, I can't figure out why they're even here. Personally, I had issues with some of those. And in the handful of cases, the Ringman Bridge is acting inconsistent and sending me to a pit of spikes that needs a screen transition. Okay, so we had that issue too. So we're more in line with Judge 4 on this one. All right, let's just move on. 23rd place. Phazon Motherbrain created Toadman's Underwater Sea Lab with a score of 68.25. Got some funky music and some Dr. Light. Darkwing Duck, below us is an underwater laboratory. Toadman built it in order to develop a nefarious device that will let him harness and enhance the water cycle's power. With the device he's building, Toadman intends to flood the planet in order to demonstrate his power to those that doubt it. You have to go in there and stop him.
All right, you know, we got a good premise going on. Toadman's pretty mad at being made fun of all the time. And he's like, "No, I am powerful. I will flood the world like Team Aqua does." Can I go back up? Can I go up more? That would have been a cool secret, but maybe they didn't realize that would have happened. All right, we got some Mega Man 5 guys and Mega Man 10 locker room guys. Well, at least I know where they're gonna show up from, but I can kind of skip all these guys, so let's just do that. And we're still skipping. Introductory. It's very, very pukey colored. I don't know if I'm a fan of that. Just keep going up. Man, so many missed opportunities for secrets. And we got some waterfalls. Good thing I didn't need to make that jump. And we have this whole idea. We've been here before. Color coding it. Maybe the water brushed off the yellow paint. Maybe should have made it gray. But color coding it was a good idea, so you know you're supposed to wait there instead of just kind of freak out. I don't know what these things are from, but I've seen them before. Maybe it's like a Mega Man 9 enemy, I just don't remember. Something. Okay, so now we're gonna take this platform up and higher. Man, it's this derpy guy again. Uh-oh. He dies way. I think, okay. When it comes to. I think he's a Game Boy mini boss, and I'm gonna say this, Game Boy mini bosses and the bosses are going to be way easier because you're quicker. And you have more room to dodge and stuff. That was made for the slow Game Boy games in small rooms. So if that's a case, if that's a my brain farted. I started focusing on squares. If it looks like they're super easy to beat, whoa, then it's because they are. Because they're not made for this kind of engine thing. This guy out of here and slide under that one. This is pretty casual so far. Man, did you see how badly I teleported? I was holding left because I expected to go left. Man. Oh shoot, you actually kind of have to. Wait, I was doing it right. I didn't even realize I did have to use the waterfall. Whoa, wow. Maybe you'll land on the purple faster than the water will go down there, so you have a chance, you know, more of a chance to get across. That's pretty scary because these waterfalls are very glitchy, and that's actually requiring it to work right. People didn't like the other stage that used these waterfalls because of their glitchy. I think it was like taking a dip or something like that. But you know, you didn't like. I would think this stage requires or relies on the mechanics working properly more than that one did, and we've only just begun this one. Now it's nighttime.
Is the waterfall gonna... I guess the waterfall can't keep coming down. And there was a little duck! Little Darkwing, what up? Ooh. Man. Stage is actually throwing some difficulty at me. But in a fair way so far. Lots of spikes. Kind of reminds me of my pit stage, overwater atmosphere. That stage almost didn't make it into the game because I threw spikes everywhere. This again, but we got some waterfalls coming, so. Increased difficulty. He died in the same exact spot as he did last time. And you can open. Also, these things die in one shot, but I'm charging anyway from increased vertical range. That wasn't a nice... No, that wasn't a nice placement for that guy at all. That was probably the worst way you could have placed him. I think there's a checkpoint. That was pretty bad. Let me see what else I could do. Yeah, I jump higher, which I don't want to do, and I shouldn't have to want to do it if I don't... Okay. That was pretty tense. That one placement maybe put him a little closer or farther, so you don't... I don't know. The creator probably expected you to want to jump. But then you get close to the spikes and you don't really prepare for that because you don't want to go close to the spikes. Woo! That's probably really hard for colorblind people. Because I'm relying on the colors to know what I should be doing. Hey, you guys are not even on the screen. Get out of here. Get out of here. And is that the stage, hopefully? That stage was okay. There was a lot of walking and I don't know. It was, that's kind of like the previous stage. I like this one a lot better, but it was weird because it was paced out where there was a lot of kind of really easy nothing going on and then it got really hard. Really weird. Maybe there needs more middle ground, moderate difficulty stuff. Really weird. How similar though. Concepts were. And we have Toadman with waterfalls. Maybe waterfalls? I don't want to get hit by the waterfall. Can you stop and do your little wiggle dance? There we go. I guess this is technically all I have to do to beat him. He's still a joke. Weren't we supposed to fight him like underwater? Okay. Oh, okay, it is over. Haha, I got you. Well, they got me, is what I'm trying to say. Haha, got you. You thought you'd have to keep playing. Oh, no. This is a lot of energy elements, even more than last time. This should be more than enough, right? Well, the only way to find out is by trying, and if it's not enough, I can just get more. Let's head out and talk to Dr. Light. Okay. Don't do it to me. We're just gonna keep going. So that stage was fun. It had that weird issue where the difficulty goes from nothing to a lot. Two stages in a row. I'm not really getting lucky here. Don't rely on the waterfall physics if they're glitchy, even if you get it in your box. They were good ideas, it's just, you know, that's not the creator's fault. But if it's glitchy, you gotta kind of tone it down a little bit. Just so it's not obnoxious. I happened to die just because it glitched me out and made me go the wrong side of the waterfall. And Toadman should have been underwater. That's what I was expecting. You know, you wouldn't be able to use the waterfalls, I understand. Honestly, maybe you could, and that would make no sense, but whatever. Toadman should have been underwater. He might have been a little more difficult somehow. Also, his rain flush wouldn't make any sense, but you know what? I don't know. That Toadman fight wasn't really hard. I was expecting a harder Toadman fight, that's the whole point! Good premise. It was still fun, I liked it, but... A few things here and there were just weird and kind of put me off. Also, it looked really gross. Just the choice of color, or, you know, if that's how the palette, or the tile set, I mean, if that's how the tile set is, maybe go with a different tile set. Or, I mean, recolor it. You don't have to go with a different one, just recolor it. That was ugly. Alright, we're just gonna move on. Oh my god. 22nd place, Kitsune Fox created Darkwing City, 68.50. I swear I'm not planning this on purpose. Hold on. Let's see, normal times. It's gonna be a short one. This will be the last one we do. Hopefully it lets me in, but Darkwing Duck and Darkwing City, let's go! I love it. E-Tanks at Otto's shop. 50 Zenny. Alright, too bad we can't cling to things above us since that's not a Mega Man mechanic. Fireman's Burning Services. So we got these things. Can you shoot them? No. I guess they're just platforms. I don't know. I've only seen them like once. Spark Power Co. Okay, so far, this stage, it already has tons of charm going on. Got, you know, not just Darkwing Duck. Sparkman seems a little crunched right here. Maybe he's not, but he looks crunched. And we got custom little graphic going on here. Cool little names. Flash Man's Disco. There you go. That's thinking with your noggin. Oh. Oh. That was a different one. That one hurt. Okay, let's try this again. I'm gonna ignore the E-Tank because I just tried to heal myself. Oh my god, big jump. And you gotta go quick. But it's not too demanding. So far we have lots of enemy types. I don't know which ones belong to the... This is a good challenge. I am screwing up because I'm trying to like figure it out and cheat it a little bit, but that was good. Hopefully these things aren't unsynced. Oh, they kind of were, maybe. That was close. I don't know if I can desync them so badly enough that I can't recover. This does kind of seem like Darkwing Duck layout. Maybe they took inspiration from certain stages. I don't know. I mean, it sounds like the music. I don't know what stage this actual track's from. And right there, you want to just keep walking because that seemed to do pretty well for me. We've seen these slow lasers before. And then there's a fast one. Thanks, Eddie. You just kind of coughed on me. I'm gonna get this one, because greed. Apparently I don't have full E-Tanks. I didn't fill up before the start of this stage, so whatever. Now we're starting to repeat the signs, which is a very normal thing to do. Come on, die! No, no, go! There we go. Very normal thing to do with NES games, but... I would like to see more signs, because they were cool and I liked them. I'm assuming I have a chance to breathe here. That's why I just stood there. This stage is good. I like it. This is just genuinely good. You take too long, dude. I just want to run every time I see one of those. Are we getting to the end? Yes. Mega Man 1 fashion. Put a big eye right at the end. Oh, that's kind of funny. They have the lyrics up there for the theme song, and they got the theme song playing in the background. And now it's time to see who the boss is, so... Let's get dangerous. The Darkwing Duck sprite actually has a lot of effort put into it. Oh, I'm fighting Darkwing Duck. It's hard, man. Why is it hard, man? Makes no sense. Oh my god. Shoot him! There we go. Does this work? It works, kind of. Ah, he jumped. I am going to use an E-Tank. Yeah, they put a lot of effort into the sprite because there's like different features like on those tornado battery things. You like spin around them and those other platforms that spin you around them. They put a lot of frames and stuff into that that wasn't normally there. So, Darkwing Duck and Darkwing City. I'm not going to get over that. That stage was fun. I liked it. I don't even remember if I had any criticisms during it. I liked pretty much everything that happened. That was cool. It wasn't super crazy, it's not super amazing, but it felt good. I'll really quickly just look through the scores. 87, 67, 54, 66, general idea. I haven't thought about Darkwing Duck in years. Yeah, me neither, until today. The graphics here are really nice. Blah, 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 blah. Yes, I agree. That'll be some personality in a stage. Yes, I agree. It was good originality, too. Did you know that if you rearrange the letters in Darkwing Duck, and then you get rid of some of the letters, and then turn the W upside down, and then squint so that the K looks like an H, and the C looks like a second A, you get Hardman? Oh, that's what it was supposed to be! Oh, good job, Judge 3, you figured it out! Way to go! It's always a pleasant surprise when you play a level that actually feels pretty right in length. Yes, I agree. The enemy placement was pretty on point. Yeah, there were... It wasn't the whole time, but it kind of felt like Darkwing Duck layout with, like, the top guy on the top there dropping things down and stuff. That stage was good. No, I liked it. That was fun. That's a good way to end this one with Darkwing Duck. I don't plan these things. Alright, so that's gonna be it for this one. Until next time, I'll see you in the next one.